Gradient descent, an algorithm to minimize a function by optimizing its parameters. This is what is gradient descent by its definition. But I was having a very tough time when I started learning gradient descent for first time. I am sure some of you might be having a difficult time understanding gradient descent and mathematics behind it. I do not say this in all my videos, but if you watch this video till end, you are going to save a lot of time and effort in understanding this particular concept. And this concept is very, very important for deep learning and neural network models. Welcome to Unfold Data Science. My name is Aman and I am a data scientist. Let us start the discussion with understanding what is gradient descent. Okay, so from this definition, it is basically an algorithm. So what is an algorithm? An algorithm is a set of instructions that works on some given data in a particular way, correct? Now let us try to relate this with a real world example. Okay, let's say you are my friend and you go and attend a mathematics test. Okay, in that mathematics test, the maximum marks is 50. Okay, you come to me and then I ask you, hey my friend, how much marks did you get? You say, guess. And then I guess something like 40. And then you say, hey, no man, 40 is too much. I'm not that intelligent. Then I say, oh, is it 30? Then you say, hey, no man, not that less also. I say, okay, is it 35? You say, you are coming close to the answer. This is exactly how gradient descent works internally. Okay. So in gradient descent, we start with a random guess, okay, and then we slowly move to the right answer or correct answer or the best answer. So what is happening in this case is we started with 40, okay, and then since 40 was wrong, so we subtracted 5 from 40 and reached to subtracted 10 from 40 and reached to 30. This 30 was also not right. So we added 5 in 30 and reached to 35, correct? If 35 is also not correct, we will move maybe one step up, two step up, one step down, two step down. This is exactly how parameters are optimized in gradient descent. Okay, so the common formula for parameter optimization in gradient descent looks like this. New value, okay? New value means in our example the new guess, okay, new value is equal to old value. Old value means the previous guess that we made, okay, old value minus step size. So step size is what I was writing as minus 5 plus 10, like that. So that is nothing but how much you want to move or how much you want to shift. That is called the step size. So new value is always the updated version of the old value adjusted against something known as step size. And this step size in the world of gradient descent in terms of mathematical formula is known as, mathematically computed as, learning rate multiplied by slope. Okay, so what is this learning rate and what is this slope? We will understand with a mathematical example. Okay, so this is how at the core parameters of the model or the function is optimized in gradient descent. Let me take an example and show you. Now in my last video also I was taking an example of a square function. So let us say there is a function. This function is a square function. So fx stands for x square. Now, how does the square function looks in xy plane? So if this is my xy plane and this is my origin, then a square function passes through origin and looks like this, correct? Now, what is our objective? What is the definition of gradient descent is? This function needs to be minimized, correct? Now, what is the minimum value this function take? This function can take minimum value as 0, which comes here. So we have to reach here by doing something. Let us try to understand what is that something. Okay, let us assume that initially the random guess in our test example was 40 and then we move to 35 or 30. Here, let us say the initial random guess is this. This is the point from where we start. Okay? We do not know from this point whether to move down or whether to go up. We do not know. How do we find out in which direction we should move to reach to this point? There comes the concept of something called as derivative. So when we compute derivative of this curve with respect to x at this point, okay, this is the same concept I was explaining in my last video. If you have not watched, you can go and watch that video. From this point, if I increase the value of x, okay, then my fx decreases. So what is my objective here? To decrease fx. Hence, from this point, the correct movement is like this. Okay. Another case would be if we start from this point. For example, from this point, when I compute the slope like this with respect to x, then what I get to know is from this point, if I increase the value of x, then the value of my function also increases. This is something what I do not want. My objective here is to reach to the minimum point, this point. So that is the reason the gradient or the slope at this point will be positive, and here the slope will be negative. So if you understand a little bit about the differentiation or derivative, the slope of this with respect to x will be 2x, and this side of the origin x will have negative values, and hence this 2x will be negative. This side of the curve, the x will be positive, and hence this value will be positive. Okay, and that is where, based on this sign, if you remember that formula, new value is equal to old value minus slope into learning rate. So whenever this minus is here, so whenever the slope becomes negative, the new value will be plus on the old value, and whenever this slope is positive, the new value will be less than the old value. This is how the slope helps in deciding which direction to move, whether to reduce x or whether to increase x to reach to this global minima. Okay, in this case we are talking about something in two-dimensional plane. Okay, this is very important, guys. Here this is my function fx, and fx is just x square, correct? But in real life scenarios, this function can have more parameters. There can be a y as well, and it can be x square plus y square. What happens when we have a function which has more than one parameters? How to optimize those functions, or what is the process of optimization? Let us take an example of a regression model, basic regression model. Okay, now how does a regression model looks like in plain form, plain vanilla form? This is how regression model looks like, correct? Y is equal to mx plus c. So in my last video as well, I was explaining you the cost function for regression model will be a function of m and c, correct? That is nothing but summation of all your actual y minus m xi plus c whole square, right? All these things whole square. I'm sorry, whole square, like this. I is equal to 1 to n. So this is how your cost function looks like for a linear regression model. Now, what is the use of a gradient descent? The use of the gradient descent is to minimize this cost function so that model fits the best way possible. So this function consists of m and c. Hence, there are two parameters here. So in our fx is equal to x square example, there was only one parameter to optimize. Here we have two parameters, m and c. So what you can imagine here, a three-dimensional graph like this. On one axis, let us say this axis, there will be this function. Let us say this is j function. On other axis, there will be m, and on third axis, there will be c. Now this function needs to be minimized for the optimal value of m and c. How to do that? Let me show you that. Some calculations for easy understanding. Don't worry, it's going to be very easy. Imagine this is your training data. Okay, so what I'm trying to do here, I'm trying to train a linear regressor using gradient descent. So how the internal mathematics works, that we will understand. So this is your training data. We have two observations, x is 1, y is 2, x is 3, y is 4. Okay, so this is my training data. So as I told, in the beginning there will be one assumption made, or one basic point to start with. For example, in my marks example, I started from 40 and then I went to 30, 35, like that. So here, these are the initial assumptions. C is equal to 0, M is equal to 1. Okay, so that is what we have to find out, right? In linear regression model, we have to optimize the cost function and we have to find the best M and C. What is the cost function for linear regression? Summation of y minus mx plus c whole square. So this is your first data point and this is your second data point. Okay, this is nothing but y minus mx plus c whole square, again y minus mx plus c whole square. So this is your cost function. This needs to be optimized or minimized, and we have to find out what is the best m and c combination. Remember, we are starting from this. Now, as I was showing in fx is equal to x square video example, we have to compute something known as gradient to know in which direction to move, right? So here I will first compute what is the optimal c. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to take the derivative of this term with respect to c. That is what I am doing here. When I take the derivative of this term with respect to c, I get, from the chain rule of differentiation that I was discussing in my last video, from the chain rule of differentiation, this 2 comes here and then this internal terms. So I'm differentiating with respect to c. So this is how it will be. Okay, now when I simplify this and I put these values, because these are my initial values, remember, I'm now just doing for c, I'm not doing for m. This is called partial derivative. So I'm just taking this, these terms, and plugging in these values, c is equal to 0 and m is equal to 1. When I plug in these values, I get this derivative as minus 4. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to update my existing c. So my new c will be my old c minus learning rate. Now what is this learning rate? Learning rate is how aggressively or how slowly you want to change your step. Okay, means if you are at 40, you want to come to 30 directly, or you want to go to 39, 38, 37. So how aggressive you are in taking your step, that is what this gives us, learning rate. So I have put learning rate as 0.001 here. And what is the slope I am getting? Minus 4. So minus 4 will be multiplied here, and new value of c will be 0.004. So we started with c 0 and the new value of c is 0.004. Similarly, this cost function will be differentiated against m, and new value of m will come. Then these two values goes away and new value of c comes here, new value of m, whatever that value is, comes here, and this entire process gets repeated till we reach the minimum cost function. Now, how does algorithm know where to stop? So there are multiple ways. So there will be a time when the value of this gradient will, you know, try a approach to zero, closely approach to zero. There will be a time when, after 1000 iterations, the gradient descent will understand that there is not much improvement on cost, and at that time it will stop. So the important things here are choosing the learning rate and deciding on how we should decide whether we should be very aggressive or whether we should be moderate. The advised way here is to be little moderate, given your data size is not too huge, because this will decide on how fast or how slow your algorithm gives you the result. So in this example, I have tried to make you understand, with the help of the cost function of linear regression, how does gradient descent does the parameter optimization in the background. I am sure I was able to explain you all these concepts in this video. Still, if you have any doubts, anything to ask me, please write that in the comment of this video. All these concepts are very, very important when it comes to neural network backpropagation and epochs in neural network, like how the weights and biases are optimized. So there, the loss function will optimize the weights, biases, and all those things. I will explain you all those concepts. So the reason I am explaining you these things is these make the base of artificial neural network and lot of other models. So if you have any doubts, let me know. I'll come up with another interesting video. Till then, stay safe and take care.